We want to simplify the given rational expressions. To do this, we need to start by factoring the numerators and denominators. We cannot simplify these expressions until they're first in factored form, meaning we cannot simplify this y squared over y squared because we cannot simplify across addition or subtraction. So looking at our first rational expression, the first step in factoring is to factor out the greatest common factor. So for y squared minus 5y, we have a common factor of y between these two terms, so we'll factor out the y, leaving us with y minus 5. Remember, we can always check this by distributing, and we do have y squared minus 5y in factored form. Our denominator is actually a difference of squares, so this will factor into two binomial factors. The first terms will be y and y, and then for the factors of negative 25, we'll use a positive 5 and a negative 5, so one factor is y plus 5, and one factor is y minus 5. And now that we have this in factored form, we can see the numerator and denominator share a common factor of y minus 5. Y minus 5 over y minus 5 simplifies to 1. So we're left with a numerator of y and a denominator of y plus 5. If we want to, we could drop these parentheses. But we cannot simplify this y and this y because of the addition. This would be our simplified rational expression. Now our second example does look a little bit more involved, but remember the first step is to factor out the greatest common factor. So looking at the numerator, notice how each term does share a factor of x. So we'll start by factoring out an x from the numerator. This would give us x times the quantity 7x squared minus 10x minus 8. And then for the denominator, notice how each term shares a common factor of 4. So we'll factor out 4, leaving us with the quantity x squared minus 3x plus 2. Now we do want to continue factoring. It looks like the denominator is going to be easier to factor, so let's factor that first. We'll still have our factor of 4 here, and then this trinomial will factor into two binomial factors. The factors of x squared would be x and x, and now we want the factors of positive 2 that add to negative 3, which would be negative 1 and negative 2, so I'll have x minus 1 and x minus 2. And now let's factor the numerator. We'll still have a factor of x here, and then we're hoping this trinomial here will factor into two binomial factors. So the first positions must come from the factors of 7x squared, which would be 7x and x. And now because our leading coefficient is not 1, we need to place the factors of negative 8 into the second positions so that the sum of the inner product and outer product would give us negative 10x. But one of the reasons I wanted to factor the denominator first is it's probably safe to assume we are going to have at least one common factor between the numerator and denominator. So when trying the factors of negative 8 into these second positions, let's try putting a minus 2 here. So if we use a factor of negative 2 here, this is going to have to be a positive 4. And let's check to see if this works. If it does, we'll have a common factor here of x minus 2. Well, the inner product is 4x, the outer product is negative 14x, and if we sum these, we would have a sum of negative 10x, which is good news because that's the middle term. So it's often helpful to use the expressions that are easier to factor the more difficult expressions when simplifying rational expressions. So again, x minus 2 over x minus 2 simplifies to 1. Nothing else simplifies, so we have x times the quantity 7x plus 4 all over 4 times the quantity x minus 1. This would be our simplified rational expression. Okay, I hope you found these examples helpful.